Hi guys. So the bear market is in full swing. We're now at a 300 billion market cap. And we're 3 months in. So I think it's important to place your bets because we don't know. Crypto always surprises and it could be like logically, this bear market will take a long time. So my previous video, I predicted 1 year and a half, and so that would be by the middle of 2019. And actually, that's for the leader, and that's Bitcoin still today. But the other coins will all find their low at a later time. And so the bear market in 2013 lasted only 1 year for Bitcoin until the whole year of 2014. But the other coins, many altcoins, only bottomed out at the end of 2015. So that took 2 years. So taking into account the cycles are getting longer, and this bull market took longer. That means that we likely get 1 year and a half for Bitcoin, but for the worst coins, like the weakest performance, will not take 1 year and a half, but double as long, 3 years before they find their low. So that's not the middle of 2019, that would be at the end of 2020. So that's just a very long time that this bear market will last, I think. But I've been very wrong in the past about these expectations, and you have to be careful for that. And it could well be that we find the low in 1 month time from here, and from there we go up into a new bull market that is already reaching new all-time highs by the end of 2018. Many people actually think that will happen. So that's possible too. So and it is possible. I think it's a low probability, but I still think it is possible. But that means, well, many people think it will actually go up from here. Although you see that bullishness is going down, people become more reserved these days. But I would say that's certainly not a majority bearish sentiment. No. I would, from what I see, estimate it at a 50-50. And so usually a bear market is only finished when actually the majority, 80-20 or 90-10, is bearish. So we're certainly not there yet. But we could be there in 1 month time if prices collapse 1 week after another, 1 day after another. It's all possible. And we could find the lows already in 1 month too, instead of in 1 year or 2 years time. So for that reason, I think it's important to place your bids, but expect them to not be filled within 1 year, possibly even 2 years, depending on for what coins you are putting up bids. So that's what I'm doing, and of course, it's also very important what coins are you gonna buy, and that's very subjective, and I have to say that my track record is not that good when it comes to coin selection. So yeah, for example, the best highest performance in the last bull market were Ethereum, Dash, Monero, and all of these coins I consciously decided not to invest in, and instead I invested in NXT, and then later on I invested in Decred, and actually that was a very very good call, and that went up a lot, and I did invest at the low and sold at the high. But my first 2 years of the bull market, 2014, well that's still a bear market, 2015-16, I was into NXT and Clumps. It was just the wrong choices, although at the end of the bull market NXT ended up going up a lot also together, because it forked into Ardor and Ignis, and if you combine the value of all these coins, actually it also was a hundred folding, a hundred multiplier. But if you compare that to Dash or Monero or Ethereum, these did a lot more than 100 multipliers. They did 300 or 500 or 1000 multipliers at the peak of the bubble. So the difference between selecting, it's a difference of 10 folding. If you pick a winner, you're gonna do 10 times more profits than when you pick, well, something that didn't perform so well. So and I've learned that the big difference, it all comes to down to adoption. You see that the coins that rose the most were the coins that succeed in getting more real world adoption. And so when you decide what coins you're gonna buy during this bear market, well, it's very important to pick coins that succeed better than other coins to get adoption in the next bull market. And that's very hard to tell which ones will be it. So I'll leave that selection to you. So that's it, guys. Place your bits, and good luck. Oh, and of course, how high should you place your bits? Don't be modest there. Look at previous bear markets and how deep it went. Well, it will not go that deep, but it will also go deep. And so, for example, Bitcoin. It went down in the first bear market in 2011 from $32 to $3. So that's minus 92%. The second bear market, it went down from $1,250 to $160, and that's minus 78%. So that's only a difference of 5%. So volatility goes down, but not that much. So what's the next bear market going to do for Bitcoin? Well, probably it will go down by not minus 87%, but no, let's say minus 80%. That's likely. And how much is that? Well, the high was 20,000 or 90,500, so that's 4,000. That will be the low for Bitcoin. Maybe a little bit lower. 82% would be not 4, but like 3,500. That's likely gonna be the low. So if you're gonna place bits, don't place it below that, because it's likely not gonna get filled. Don't put everything on that, because that's too risky. Put it like in ladders above that, above 3,500. You put your bits, let's say between 5,000 and 3,500. It's for Bitcoin, and the same you do with the other coins. You look at previous bear markets, and then you deduct some volatility and you place your bids there. For example, Ethereum, Bitcoin Cash, Ripple, the market leaders, let's say the top 5, top 10, you can compare them to, well, the top 5, top 10 of the last bear market. So that was also Ripple, but also Litecoin. If you look at these coins, they collapsed a lot more than Bitcoin in the last bear market. These were also new coins. Litecoin only had experienced the bull market because it only appeared on the scene after the first bull market of Bitcoin in 2011. Then Litecoin appeared, and so it went up in one straight line. The same happened with Dash and Monero and Ethereum. It came only on the market after the last bull market of 2013. So they launched all in 2014, and they went up in one straight line. Maybe the first year not, because it was a bear market, but after that they went up, and they went up tremendously. But they never experienced a real bear market. So these coins, you really have to prepare for serious, like, deep corrections. And so for Litecoin, that was minus 97%. For Ripple, that was minus 95%, the previous bear market. It will not go that deep, because market caps are a lot higher these days. But minus 90% is a modest and realistic estimation for these coins. So Bitcoin minus 80%, but the other ones, the top 10, minus 90%. So for Ethereum, that means the peak was interestingly, $1,450, and so that's $145. That will likely be the low. For Monero, I think it was $300, $400, so minus 90%, that's $30, $40. And then you have Bitcoin Cash, it was also $1,450, the same amount as Ethereum. So there too. Yeah. Wait, am I correct here? No, I'm wrong. Sorry. Bitcoin Cash is $4,350, and so minus 90% is $430. So yeah. Place your bids there and above. But that's when it goes minus 90%. Maybe it goes a little bit more. It can go minus 95% also. It's in a flash crash, it's possible. And so that's half of that. So. But I also would be cautious, be careful not to place it too low, because it may be, if you miss that opportunity, I mean, it could really a big miss, a big loss in opportunity, because I think it is very likely that we get another big bubble in cryptocurrency. And so, if you miss buying on these lows, you might have to chase the price, and you might decide never to do it, and this might make a big difference financially. Because we can expect these coins to go again times hundreds, huh? And that's crazy, but cryptocurrency is a new asset class, and it will become a lot bigger than its current market cap in the long run. It will become as big as the fiat currencies of today, and that's not 1 trillion, but that's 100 trillion. So that's the potential here, and we went to almost 1 trillion, but now we corrected to 300 billion. So the next bubble, we probably will find a low here around 100 billion or 150 billion, and so after that it's again 100x. We go to not 1 trillion but 10 trillion. So these are the potential returns. But I think personally the odds are the highest for this to happen only in like 4 or 5 years from here, and not now. Not this year, 2018. No, we will find the low in 2019, and we found the low of many other coins only in 2020. And after that goes up, and it will take a lot longer than previous bull market, not 3 years, but probably 4 years before we find the high. So 2020 plus four, that's 2024. 2025, 2024. That's when I expect 10 trillion, and not this year. Oops. So voilà, I'm gonna leave it at that. Thank you so much for watching, and wish you all a great day. Bye.